Hi, my name is Dave Reed, and I'm with Cook Medical, Vice President of Healthcare Solutions. And today I'm going to talk about the significantly growing generation gap with supply chain leaders. All of us have been in healthcare for a period of time, and there have been significant changes that are coming at the industry in significant ways. As an industry, we have three elements of our mission. There are more, but there are certainly three. One is to take care of more patients as the generations age. The second one is do this with equal to or less money than is in the system now. And the third thing is to ensure that we have outcomes that are equal to or better than we have today. With the demands on the healthcare system, this really puts us in an interesting opportunity to be able to think about how do we align ourselves around costs, around quality, and around outcomes. And in more recent days, we've heard a lot about a clinically integrated supply chain system. But as we begin to go down this road, there are some interesting challenges that we have as an industry. When you take a look back historically at supply chain in healthcare, it really started many, many years ago in a warehouse called materials management. And a lot of people knew there were supplies in the hospital, but they really did not know anything about it, where they were, how it worked, anything behind the scenes. And those that have been involved in materials management in its early days, supply chain now, were really actually pretty good at ensuring that products showed up at the right place for clinical application, and they did it with very limited personnel and certainly without any technology advantages. And today, there are a lot of opportunities with healthcare that can enable us to be able to do these things much quicker, much faster, and with much more accuracy. And in order to do that, there really requires some additional work, both on the individuals who are engaged in the system and certainly on the processes and procedures that healthcare systems use to be able to effectively manage their supply chain. So as we think about gaps that are occurring today in supply chain leadership, there are really two things to consider. One is that over the next few years, 3 to 5 years, and certainly in 10, there will be a number of individuals that will be retiring. Additionally to that, there are, on the other side of the spectrum, significant interest by younger generation individuals who have either had expertise in supply chain in other industries or have been trained both in supply chain or in financial management that come into the industry and are equipped with tools and items that the historic generation never had. So as we think about how to solve these challenges, it really brings to the fore an opportunity where we have a historic generation of leaders who have a lot of knowledge. They have a lot of what I call tribal knowledge about how things work inside of healthcare systems, why they work the way they do, why they don't work the way they do, but certainly a vast amount of knowledge. And quickly, that is moving into the retirement era. But we have on the other side tools, technology, applied use of skill sets that have been developed either through education or other industries that now can be brought to bear inside of supply chain and healthcare. And it's not either or. And I think that's really where the opportunity lies to ensure we minimize this gap. Time is running out. As people begin to retire, which is happening in increasingly numbers, that knowledge will walk away with them. So what we need to ensure occurs is that a combination or a bridging, if you will, of historic supply chain leaders with the next generation of supply chain leaders and find a way through change management to be able to work collaboratively with each other to ensure that we can accomplish the goals of healthcare. In order to do that, you're going to really need some individuals who are very happy to kind of work through the change management process. And that's not for everybody. It's really easy for the historic generation to say, well, we've always done it this way. This is how we should do it. We shouldn't really change. But it's also, on the other side, really easy for next generation leadership to come in and say, I've got all the tools. I know the tricks. I've applied this elsewhere. This will directly apply to supply chain. And quite honestly, neither one works well. I believe there is a middle ground. And the middle ground is really a collaboration effort between historic and next generation, where we apply best practices in both parts. And those individuals work collaboratively together on projects, some of them small, to be able to gain competency and gain trust in each other so that actually we can accomplish the goals of supply chain inside of healthcare. In order to do this, those individuals really have to be willing to work with each other. I believe they need to start small. They need to pick projects that are doable, attainable, and allow them to show some early success. That early success will also be key and critical to being able to have high-level conversations in the C-suite inside of healthcare systems to show relevancy, to show how this works, to show the possibilities of what can be accomplished on a going-forward basis. In order to really find ourselves in an opportunity where this idea of cost, quality, and outcomes transitions into a clinically integrated supply chain, I believe that these two sets of individuals really need to come together, work collaboratively, and allow the fruits of that work really to manifest itself in the next couple of years. As I indicated earlier, this is really a call to action now, because as these next generation leaders begin to move on, we don't want to lose that knowledge. But we also need to realize that as new generation of individuals come into the healthcare supply chain, we need to allow them to be free with their ideas. And I believe the ideas of both old and new working collaboratively actually will enable us to be very successful in the future and really accomplish that CQO goal that we talk about at AHRMM a lot, which today translates into a very robust, clinically integrated supply chain. I'm David Reed, and thank you for watching.